I love my cat, and I'm pretty sure she loves me because she does this all the time. Some people call this behavior kneading or making biscuits, but why exactly do domestic cats do this? First, I feel like I need to say something because this is really bugging me. Kneading is for developing the gluten in dough, like making a delightfully stretchy pizza crust or a satisfyingly chewy piece of bread. Food science. But biscuits need to be treated gently. If you overwork biscuit dough or knead it, you will get really crappy biscuits with none of the yummy flakiness you're expecting. So if we put dough under Puzzle's paws, she would definitely be kneading, but not making biscuits. Was I supposed to be talking about animal behavior? Right, so many domestic cats of all ages do this thing where they seek out a soft surface, like a blanket or a pillow or your stomach, and then they rhythmically push into the area with their paws, alternating them like this. Oh, and if the cat isn't declawed, which hopefully it's not, this might hurt a bit, but honestly, I'd rather receive several thousand tiny love punctures from my cat than chop all of her toes off at the first knuckle.
525,600 punctures, how do you measure the love of a cat?
A lot of the popular science articles I could find online covering this question suggested that kneading is a way for cats to reduce stress. While I couldn't find any scientific articles to directly back this up, I did find some tangentially related support. I cannot believe that it took until 1995 for someone to publish a paper on this, and it might come as a bit of a shocker, but did you know that cats like pillows? Yeah. The researchers for this study added pillows to the enclosures where groups of laboratory cats were living, and guess what? The cats laid on the pillows! More importantly, before there were pillows in their enclosures, the only soft place for the cats to sleep was in the litter box. So yeah, who knew? Pillows are better than sleeping in your own shit. All jokes aside, the real reason this article is relevant is that the researchers noted none of the cats did the kneading or treading behavior in their enclosures before the pillows were added, but once a cat had a pillow, it spent more than 4% of its time every day kneading. So kneading is something cats really only seem to do on soft surfaces like blankets, pillows, and laps, and it could have something to do with de-stressing. But a more compelling argument was also put forward by the PopSci articles. Kneading is a kitten behavior that cats continue doing into adulthood. This argument made a lot of sense to me because the phenomenon of adult animals retaining characteristics of their juvenile states, called neoteny, is something we see a lot in domesticated animals. For instance, my dog has droopy ears, a shorter nose, smaller teeth, and bigger eyes proportional to her face than an adult wolf. She's more puppy-like, which makes her cuter to us, therefore we're more likely to keep her around. But honestly, who could say no to this face? Again, though, I struggled to find scientific citations to support this hypothesis. Is this because I was putting the wrong search terms into Google Scholar, or because this is one of those answers people think is so obvious they never thought to explore it? Probably the first one. However, I did find a review paper that states, "A third common form of tactile communication is kneading with the forepaws, the action which kittens use on their mothers to stimulate milk flow." That statement was not followed by a citation to any other article, so that either means we can say those authors are the originators of the idea, or more likely, that they didn't provide a citation because they considered that statement to be common knowledge. But let's go with it, even sans citation. Basically, what these authors and all of the PopSci articles are saying is that, as kittens, cats use a pushing motion with their paws against the soft surface of their mother's abdomen to stimulate her mammary glands to produce and expel milk. Makes sense. Food, especially milk for infants, is one of the basic necessities of all animals, and also something that usually brings us pleasure because it tastes good and makes us not hungry. So we could argue that the behavior is neotenous, and that our pet cats are treating us like their mommies, even when they're all grown up. Interestingly, the authors of this review suggest that kneading isn't a truly neotenous behavior, though, because it can disappear without reinforcement. They state, "The meow and kneading may simply not disappear from an individual cat's repertoire as it matures, simply because they have been reinforced through interaction with the owner." Apparently nobody ever told Puzzle, because my husband stops her from kneading in bed every night because it's distracting frustrating and painful, and yet she persists in doing it all the time. So, what have we learned? Well, I found out there are a lot of PopSci articles that already try to answer this question, so RIP my view count from YouTube suggestions. But I was also surprised to learn that there may not be as much concrete research on this question as I originally thought. However, if you do know of any papers on this topic, feel free to drop those citations down in the comments section. And if you're a behavioral researcher, maybe this is a topic that deserves more attention. Regardless of the research, though, I think it's really sweet that my cat likes to spend time with me and sometimes needs on me, even if it's also kind of painful. We love each other, and that's what matters. Do you have a pet cat? If so, does it do the needing behavior on you? What other questions do you have about pets and their behaviors? I'd love to hear your thoughts down in the comments. If you liked this video, don't forget to like it. If you didn't like this video, please share it with someone who would. And if you'd like to support The Roving Naturalist, remember to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon. Then go check out my Patreon page. You can also follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. If you just can't get enough science in your life, you can watch me twice a month on twitch.tv/naturecheckd. Where a bunch of other scientists and myself play Dungeons and Dragons while talking about science. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.